Hi there. I am doing the 7 questions on wehappytrans.com. My name is Bailey J. At least that's the name I go by on the internet. There is a chance that most of you, or some of you, know who I am and may even have a preconceived notion of who I am and what I stand for. But you might be wrong, or you might be right. I don't know. It depends. I'm very nervous because I'm self-conscious. And that is my husband talking in the other room. So, yes, question one down. My name is Bailey J. I would have to say that the person who's been the most supportive of me would have to be my grandmother, which was a surprise. Actually, I don't really know if she was the most supportive or if maybe I was just surprised at her, if she would be supportive at all. And so it kind of stands out to me the most. But my grandmother, she's a work in progress, but she understands on some level what I'm doing with my transition. And she, when I first said, I think I might be transgendered, she was like, okay, I'm glad you figured it out because I kind of knew that something was up. And she was glad that I had figured it out on some level. And then the next day she goes, oh, honey, the nice homosexual guy in the office gave me this number. And which is her way of being politically correct. And she's a secretary, and I guess there was a homosexual man in her office who gave her the number for a hormone clinic. And that's actually how I started hormones. Granted, it was Premarin, and it made me gain lots of weight and cry a lot. And I ultimately did not continue to take Premarin, but it started me on my journey to living my authentic life. So, kudos, Grandma, and nice homosexual office gentleman. Question two, down. I have a really cheesy cliche for all of you, but I think what I enjoy the most is when I live my life and I'm being myself and I'm not even thinking about it. And then I periodically would go to the bathroom to look in the mirror, or if I go to look in the mirror at any point during the day, I see exactly what I feel and it matches up. And that's cliche and probably not too original, but that is genuinely a really good feeling. Not, because what used to happen is I'd be this person on the inside and I'd be going about my life, and then I'd go to the mirror and I would see a little chubby boy with a bowl cut who looked alarmingly like DJ from Roseanne, the little boy, which you might be able to see if I get rid of all this. You can kind of see how I would look like that little boy. But yeah, now I'm not like constantly looking in the mirror like, oh, that's right, that's what I look like. Like it feels good because it's like, oh, right, I'm like a chick now or whatever. That's amazing. Not too profound. I don't want that on my tombstone. I'm a chick or whatever. But yeah. It feels good to have things match up like that. Question three, down. I'm not really one to have role models normally, but I've recently found a few. In the trans community, my current role model is Kate Bornstein. I started reading this lovely book, 101 Alternatives to Suicide for Teens, Freaks, and Other Outlaws by Kate Bornstein, also known as Hello Cruel World. This book has really helped me, and I've only just started it, but I've already marked up pages and underlined things, and it's been amazing. And I don't feel bad about not knowing if I feel like a woman, or I know I don't feel like a man, but when I feel like gender is such a blurry subject, and I wonder, do I feel like a woman, or do I, you know, what do I feel like, or what do I identify as? Or I definitely like female pronouns. Those seem to fit great. At least I think it's pronouns. I don't, but I don't know. I don't know what gender I am. I don't, I think I might just be transgendered. I don't know. And that's not saying all transgendered women are not women. That is saying that Bailey doesn't know what Bailey's gender is. And Bailey likes using her third person to describe herself. But yeah, it felt good. I don't feel guilty for not knowing what gender I am. And Kate Bornstein has helped me realize that that's okay. And that I don't have to prove to anybody in the trans community that I'm anything. Whether or not I keep my penis, or whether or not I don't feel like any particular gender all the time. Kate Bornstein's made me realize that it has to do with myself, and I don't have to prove myself to anybody in the community. And we'll get more on that towards the later questions about, like, what do I do and stuff. I guess I could start with a change I'd like to see in the trans community. I'm not a big fan of the infighting, like trans women fighting trans women, or trans women fighting with trans men, or, you know, vice versa. It's kind of like self-defeating, I feel, for an already pretty small community in comparison, I guess, to other communities. For us to fight each other, it kind of like, it just doesn't really make much sense, because we can't really move forward if we're all fighting with each other. Like, you're not using the right terminology, or, you know, if you want to keep your penis, that means you're this and you're not really a whatever. And it's a lot of anger. And I feel like there's a lot of, like, misplaced emotion there, because, well, we're trans people, or trans women, and there's obviously a lot going on there. And I could be dead wrong, and I'm sure on the internet people won't be shy about letting me know if I am, but I just feel like we're not the enemy, each other, and like, I'm Bailey J, and I'm known for doing adult work, and that doesn't mean drinking coffee and reading the newspaper. I do adult work, like, I get naked, and that makes some trans people, usually trans women, very angry with me. And they think I'm, like, perpetuating the misleading stereotype that trans women are oversexed, or that we're only good for sexy things or something. Or, like, we're either, which I understand, we're either the butt of the joke, or we're, you know, some sort of sexual thing. And I understand that. But I also feel that I have the right to do porn the same way anybody else does, regardless of if I'm trans. If I'm comfortable and consenting, and that is, in my life, the only way I can make money, as opposed to living in a freaking shack like I was as a kid, I really don't have to explain that to anybody, and it doesn't make me less trans, it doesn't make me an enemy to the trans community. But yeah, I want to see less infighting, because, like I said, I think it's misplaced. I think it's misplaced anger, and I think if you're transgendered and you're angry, you have a right to be angry. But I guess sometimes, me included, we all need to kind of keep an eye on who we're directing our anger at, and kind of just use our passion for good. And I'm taking my own advice here. Like, I'm saying this to myself as I'm saying it to the webcam at the moment. Because with infighting comes gossip and stuff. And in the trans erotica community, when I first popped on the scene, I was a little gossip, and I was catty, and it wasn't cute. I was 19, and I was an imbecile, but I'm trying to change. I'm trying to do what's right. I'm just growing up, and I don't know. And not to sound like a cornball, but I'm just a work in progress. And right now, I feel like a person who wants to reach out to every trans person. person there is and like give them a super long hug. And not like how I've hugged those other trans people in my videos. I mean, like, really, just like, I don't know. I want to have an Oprah moment. And I want to help the community in any way I can. And I want to do it without an angry tone. I want to do it with a fun tone. And I don't want to be all heavy and annoying and sappy. That is all. I am reaching out to the community. I'm not being catty. I'm trying not to gossip. Actually, I haven't been gossiping. I've been pretty good. At least not about trans girls anyway. I'm still gossipy. I'm working, like I said, work in progress. But, the biggest way, I guess I'm trying to stop the infighting in the transgendered community, or the, even I guess the smaller community of like trans erotica community, is I'm not trying to lower other girls to make myself feel more elevated, and I'm not catty, and I'm not nitpicking, and I'm basically trying to get rid of that competitive element, at least within myself, getting rid of that competitive element in the trans community, and especially the trans erotica community, where I'm not comparing myself to other girls. And believe me, I did. When I first got on the scene, I was like, that girl looks like this, and that girl needs to go get electrolysis. And I was like, whatever, just what everybody was doing. And it was stupid. And I was 19, and I was just, I was sending up a flare, basically like an emergency flare gun. I was sending up a flare of like, hi, everybody. I feel incredibly insecure in my own skin. As a woman, as a transgendered woman, as whatever, I was very insecure. And so anytime I was being catty or trying to put others down, I was just making that very clear to people that I have so much self-loathing. And I'm learning to like myself. And what I'm learning now is that the more I like myself, the less I want to hurt others. And that feels really good. And also, the other side of that coin is that when others try to hurt me, they're sending up that same flare gun that says, hi, I'm really uncomfortable in my own skin. And I see myself in them. And I have complete empathy. And I get it. And there's no way to say that without sounding like such a dummy. But I get that they're insecure. And I'm insecure. So I get it. And I think we can all stop, because we know what we're actually doing. And we can just not be embarrassed and move forward and stop with the infighting. We're not the enemy. There's too much freedom to be had for us to be all turning on each other for not using the right terminology or whatever. So, and once again, I'm not saying that I'm the guru and I'm giving advice. I'm saying this is what I'm trying to do for myself, because I'm tired of being stupid. Thank you. All right. Well, I already mentioned that I do naked stuff on the internet, but something unique about me. Well, I love horror movies. Horror, not horror movies. Horror. That's all my little B movies and horror films that I'm obsessed with. I'm obsessed with Elvira and the Munsters and all that stuff. And I even have Vincent Price on my cell phone. And I actually host a show now. Well, it's going to be a web series. It hasn't gone up yet. It should go up by Halloween, called Shemalia's Film Fiasco. And I basically make fun of old schlocky B movies and stuff like that. And that's the stuff I like doing more than porn, but that stuff doesn't pay the bills yet. So I kind of like have to take my top off, and then I get to do the things I want to do, which has been working out for me pretty well so far. I don't really know if any of this is unique. It's just kind of like me. It's the real me, not the character, not whatever. But I host Third Gender Radio every other Wednesday. You can check that out on thirdgenderradio.com. It's like a transgender advice show. Jen has been on it twice, which is pretty sweet. And I host the Bailey J Show, which is not quite It's kind of weird. It's kind of like if Third Gender Radio was Simon and Garfunkel, then the Bailey J Show would just be like the most obnoxious, like butt rock, like I don't even know, like Nickelback. It's just like blah, like I'm just yelling, and it's we do it at nighttime with two guy hosts, and I drink and carouse, and it's like the opposite. But yeah, so I do both those shows. Now Shumelia's Film Fiasco, which will be going up in Halloween and all that stuff. I'm married. I live upstate in a quiet little suburban area, and my neighbor is like a white witch, like health nut. She's like 60 and she's awesome, and she knows I'm transgendered. She's fine with it, which was a huge relief because I was worried that you know, everybody would burn me at the stake because I'm very open about being transgendered with people. And, yeah. I'm trying to be more open all the time. And I'm being very open in this video, which is part of the reason why I was so afraid to do the video, because I was worried I would be, like, under the microscope or being made fun of or something within the community. And that's probably my own paranoia because, like I said, I get a lot of really positive feedback from trans women, and it's just, you know how it is, that sometimes the negative feedback is what sticks, especially for someone with anxiety and, you know, potential for self-loathing. But yeah, I guess I live a pretty normal life and a pretty abnormal life all at the same time. But yeah, I'm married, like I said, wedding ring. There's actually, it's a picture of me on my wedding day. I've actually never shown that to anybody before. Obviously in my line of work as being a nudie cutie of sorts, I, don't exactly show pictures of me in a wedding dress. but I figure I'm talking to family now, and it felt good to share that. And I'm sure I'll be under scrutiny from other people, but I really hope within my own community that I receive nothing but love, because that's all I'm sending out right now. And that's me in a nutshell, I suppose. And I really hope that I can serve my community as I get older. And I hope you guys will let me. And yeah, I really, really appreciate the chance to make this video. Like I said, I was terrified, but now I'm glad I did, and I'm kind of putting it out there. And I want to make more fun shows for everybody, and I hope I can serve. That's my thing. That's how I'm defeating my anxiety right now, is I'm trying to remember, like, and this is like the truest statement ever for me, like every time I get anxiety, I'm kind of trying to think, how may I serve? How may I serve? How may I serve? And that's, I'm kind of doing that in terms of the trans community. Like, it's like when I get anxious, I try to think of the greater good, like all those ants in Africa that link together to make the raft of ants and they float. I kind of want to do that. I'm a freak of nature. But yeah, so I, how may I serve? That's kind of like my motto for the moment. Anytime I get anxious, it's like, what could I do for the trans community? And, right now, it's just doing Third Gender Radio, and doing Shumelia's Film Fiasco, my funny Elvira show. That will be up soon, and I hope everyone can watch it, and it'll be really funny. And hopefully, you're not offended because my character's name is Shumelia, because it's, I kind of make a couple puns about being transgender, and it's like Shumel. It's all very tongue in cheek, and if you don't laugh, you'll cry. And I refuse to cry. I wear far too much eye makeup to cry. So, yeah, I'll Tammy Faye Baker it, or I'll look like Alice Cooper. Anyway, thank you for listening to me ramble, and thank you.